Anastasia.
Hello, you guys. How are you doing? I hope y'all are having a fine day today. So, I know I said I was going to do this daily. I'm not even going to get into it and give y'all excuses. I'm going to just get into it. So, for this episode, I'm going to be talking about Angela Bofill. If you didn't know who that is, all right, she is a very, 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 very legendary individual. And she has been in the music business for quite some time. She hasn't been performing recently due to medical reasons. Her prime time was, you know, in the 80s. But we're about to get into her. I'm about to tell you all about Angela Bofill.
Far through time she has traveled, and she's watching out of sight.
Angela Bofill's most popular song was Angel of the Night, and it was released October 10th, 1979. All right. Angela Tomessa Bofill is an American singer, songwriter of Cuban Puerto Ricans original. A New York native, Bofill began her professional career in the mid-1970s. Bofill is most known for singles such as This Time I'll Be Sweeter, Angel of the Night, as you just heard, and I Try. Bofill's career spans for 4 decades. All right. So, she was born May 2nd, 1954, in the Brooklyn area of New York City, to a Cuban father and a Puerto Rican mother, raised in the Bronx. Bofill grew up listening to Latin music and was also inspired by African American performers. During Bofill's childhood, her weekends were taken up studying classical music and singing in New York City's All City Chorus, excuse my voice, which featured the best singers from all of high schools in the 5 boroughs. For high school, Bofill attended Hunter College High School, graduating in 1972. Bofill later studied at the Manhattan School of Music, receiving a Bachelor of Music degree in 1976. Bofill began her professional career singing during her teenage years. Bofill performed with Ricardo Morero and the group and dance theater of Harlem Chorus before being introduced to David Grusin and Larry Rosen of the jazz label GRP Records by Dave Valentine, her friend and jazz flutist. Grusin and Rosen signed Bofill and produced her first album, Angie, in 1978. Angie was well received both critically and commercially and included the chart single, This Time I'll Be Sweeter. And Bofill's sprawling jazz composition, Under the Moon and Over the Sky, less than a year later, a second album, Angel of the Night, was released and outperformed its predecessor. The album included the chart singles What I Wouldn't Do and the up-tempo title track, as well as the song I Try, written by Bofill and covered by Will Downing in 1991, and yours truly, Lindsey Anastasia, me. Okay, the reception of these albums positioned Bofill as one of the first Latina singers to find success in the R&B and jazz markets. So the main reason why I wanted to cover Angela Bofill is because I just did 2 covers to one of her, to to her song on Angel of the Night, to her songs. I did I Try, as I just told you guys, and I also did The Feelings Love. So that's streaming everywhere. I even released two music videos, and it's doing pretty popular. Also, if you didn't know, I am a Black Latina myself, okay? I am Afro-Puerto Rican. Yes, y'all. So I do have some Puerto Rican in my culture. I know Angela Bofill, she is Cuban Puerto Rican. I mean, I'm just Black and Puerto Rican, but you know, I've felt a lot of similarities in her music. Listening to her tracks, the way her voice is, I could definitely relate to it a lot. I'm grateful that I was able to cover her music and that I have not been hit anything. A lot of people have enjoyed it. Let me go ahead and let me play some of it for you guys. Okay.
Can you let my world in just a little bit? Because it's about you all the time.
It's not about me all the time. I've made a judgment. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what a judgment time you made.
Best I can for you, but it seems it's not enough. And you know I care, even when you're not there. But it's not what you want.
just the other day when you passed right by me.
How did I know it was gonna be?
I really wanted to say, baby, come on and trap me.
Trap me, baby.
Cause the feeling.
So that is me, all right? And here is Angela Bofill presenting an award to young Michael Jackson for Thriller. So as you can see, I don't know if you can hear it in her voice, but Angela Bofill, she seemed like a very, very humble individual. She was very nice and sweet. Never read anything bad about her at all. Okay, so continuing with her story, we all know who Clive Davis is, and he showed interest in Bofill. All right, so Bofill has switched labels for her next album, Something About You, 1981, and it was produced by narrator Michael Walden. The album was an attempt to move Bofill into mainstream R&B and pop music. Honestly, I feel like she could have gotten there if she was not working with Clive Davis. I'm sorry. The people that she seemed to be working with before, they seem to have been doing a really good job of putting her on, but her voice was so angelic and so strong. A lot of people compare her to like an opera singer because she just had very strong vocals. And I guess performing with a lot of bands. Also, she plays some instruments herself. She was trying to network with certain individuals that she thought would bring her up. And that didn't seem to go too well. So it says here, from what I have, it didn't perform as well as previous releases, despite the single Holding Out for Love and the title track, which both reached the R&B top 40. So I feel like the reason why is because of the type of song they had her singing. If I'm being honest, I'm not going to play that here. It's not one of my favorites. No offense. But you know, I feel like it was the kind of song. I feel like she should have just stuck with what was working with her, like what was working for her. But it's the fact that she started working with Clive Davis, you know, probably promised her all of this, these things, which of course never happened, but she was still a legend. She was still awesome. Okay. So, she went ahead and she went back to Walden after that, as you can guess. So she's been covered by Jennifer Holliday, and several other popular artists. She's really beautiful. She wrote all of her music, like most of it was original. So she was very, very talented. She could play instruments. She can sing for damn sure. In the early 2000s, she was still performing. When she returned to the stage, for the Angela Bofill Experience, that's what it was called, she had lost her ability to sing. She had two strokes, okay, in 2007, which is terrible. And basically she just had to sit down. She started having health issues. Now I was trying to look for some recent interviews that she did. And she did do a recent interview with Essence. Okay. This was back in 2020. So, that's good. I'm glad that we have some sort of update. Something as recent as 2024. That was in 2020, but you know. So there were some rumors that was spreading around after, you know, she had two strokes and basically she had to sit down. She had to be in hospitality care. You know what I mean? Had to be around family. And there were some rumors that she had died. So that's the main reason why this interview happened. Because a lot of people thought that she died because they just wasn't hearing about her and she wasn't around. So I'm going to read from the interview with Essence. How did you find out that you supposedly died? Laughs. Well, a lot of calls confirming if it's true. Friends calling up. Oh my God, am I talking to the ghost of Angela Bofill? Thank God it's not true. How did it feel when fans started posting tributes? Was it nice to feel the love or was it eerie? Of course. You always must welcome love, I figured. They really like me. I'm just laughing at it, really. It's better to have a sense of humor. It made me think of saying, give people their flowers while they can still smell them. Because you deserve that. Bofill. Thank you. My daddy always told me growing up, when I die, you have a big party. I understand that now. But you're not burying me yet. I have to stick around and see all those grandchildren. I have to graduate high school and college. I love life. How is your health now? I know you're having dialysis 3 times a week. Bofill. When I was 4 years old, they removed my right kidney, and for years and years I didn't need dialysis. Eventually one kidney working for two kidneys took its toll. You're living with your daughter, your son-in-law, and 4 grandchildren. How's that going? Bofill. God bless them. A lot of children don't take care of their parents. Just put them in a nursing home and bye-bye. Latin and African American people are accustomed to respect their elders. How difficult has it been for you not being able to sing since you had your strokes? Well, to tell you the truth, I was happy to have a break. After 25 years straight on the road, celebrating birthdays and holidays, it's been really marvelous. If you could magically perform one of your songs again, which one would it be? Bofill. Children of the World United. That's from her first album, Angie. The message is pertinent in our time still. I believe in this positive thinking. Do you ever play any of your old albums around the house? Yeah, you know, sometimes Angel of the Night is my favorite. Denzel Washington has called you his favorite singer. Tell me about that. Bofill, yes. Denzel went to one of my Blue Note shows in New York, and I'd never heard of him before. My assistant was fading. Oh my God, Denzel told me I was his favorite singer? And I said, really? Thank you so much. Being a Latina, you were embraced by Black women as one of their own, as part of the family. Bofill, well, you know, why not? Music is a universal language. It's really flattering, really. What has been the career highlight for you? Bofill. I was nominated for an American Music Award in 84, and I presented Michael Jackson a trophy for favorite soul R&B album after Diana Ross invited me to the after party. So that was exciting. Diana really liked my outfit. Also, I was seated next to Rick James. My favorite, Rick James. So there you have it. That is her interview with Essence. And I'm so glad I had played that reaction for you. And looking at the video, like, Angela Bofill was so excited to present Michael with that award. She, you know, like, I've never met her, but just listening to her music and listening to that interview kind of just made me a little emotional, because she's really a bright person. And I'm so honored that she allowed me, or whoever was in charge of the songs, I'm pretty sure, you know, probably struck something in her, you know, maybe if she heard about it. But I'm just so grateful that she allowed me to cover her songs. Haven't received any issues, got the licensing and stuff taken care of. But I'm very grateful for it. She's a beautiful woman. She's very talented. And it's a pleasure to be able to sing them. I was so inspired by her, just listening to her music. You don't hear that much about her. People don't speak that much about her. She was someone that had dreams, and she definitely deserves to be counted for when it comes to this podcast, and when it comes to just music legends in general. I'm honored. Angela, if you're listening to this, you're amazing. I can tell you have a very beautiful spirit, from the music that you wrote, from the way that you speak, from the way that you smile. Wonderful. I'm blown away, and I'm very, very grateful. So that's what I have for you guys today. Also, I am on YouTube now. I'm going to be using YouTube to promote this more. So, if you guys can check out my website to get to the YouTube for this podcast, or you could just type in Sweet Melodies and you should see it. But have a blessed day, guys. I hope you enjoyed this podcast today. Have a wonderful